A rare disease that could be connected to COVID-19 is now in West Michigan. Doctors at Helena Voss Children's Hospital says they are now treating 3 cases of Kawasaki disease. It's most commonly seen in children under 5. These cases, all the children are under 10. 13 on Your Side health reporter Val Lego spoke to an infectious disease specialist who says we should expect more cases.
I am talking with Dr. Rosemary Olivero. She is the Division Chief for Pediatric Infectious Diseases at Helena Voss Children's Hospital. I want to talk a little bit more about these cases of Kawasaki disease that we are finding now in West Michigan. How concerned do parents need to be about this? Obviously, they're reading the headlines in the national news.
Yeah, so this is certainly something to be looking out for. The reassuring thing is that still children in all areas of the United States are generally still not getting severely ill from the novel coronavirus. However, we have learned both from cases in the United States and in Europe that Kawasaki disease or an inflammatory syndrome related to the novel coronavirus is something that we're learning more and more about and we may be seeing more cases of. Still within the United States, we have less than 100 cases total. So it's certainly not at a panic level, but I think it's worthwhile for parents to have this in the back of their mind in case their child starts developing some symptoms, just to really prompt them to seek medical care.
And what are those symptoms?
Sure, so the symptoms of Kawasaki disease are prolonged fever. So having a fever that lasts at least 4 to 5 days in duration, and not just the fever like, oh, my child feels a little warm, has flushed cheeks. You actually wanna check your child's temperature. And a temperature of 101 or greater would be considered a fever. So having that fever for 4 to 5 days at a minimum. Also having a red coloration to your eyes, having a rash, so any type of rash, anything that looks kind of flushed or bumpy on the skin would be considered a rash. And then some changes to the lips. So the lips start to usually look a bright red color. They may get swollen and cracked. And then the tongue also can look like a beefy red color, almost like a strawberry. And actually the tongue can look just like a strawberry in some of these cases. And the other thing to look out for is changes of the hands and feet. The hands and feet generally become puffy, swollen, and sometimes to the point where the kids can't even close their hands all the way. So those are the kind of things to start to look out for if your child is having that prolonged fever illness.
And then should they be calling their pediatrician or should they be bringing them to the emergency room?
That's a great question. So I would still start with calling your pediatrician's office because it's a very safe place for children to get care. And most pediatricians can see the child in the office, determine if they would meet the criteria for Kawasaki disease or if they need to get some labs to help support that diagnosis or not. Now, on the flip side of the coin, if your child has these features of Kawasaki disease, but is just looking very ill to you, if they're not breathing normally, if they're really not eating or drinking or making good urine, if they're just really super tired and not getting up like you would normally expect them to, then I would say I would have taken them directly to the emergency room.
And do children recover from this without any sort of long-term effects?
That's a great question. So the main importance of Kawasaki disease and in diagnosing it is that this is an inflammatory condition where certain blood vessels in the body can get very inflamed. And there are some very important blood vessels that surround the heart and provide blood flow to the heart. Those are called your coronary arteries. In Kawasaki disease, those coronary arteries can get very inflamed to the point that they actually dilate and get bigger than normal. And the whole problem with that is then you can actually get clots in those blood vessels and then you could have a heart attack. So that can happen in Kawasaki disease if it's not diagnosed and treated in a timely fashion. So before, usually around 10 days of illness is when we would start seeing the higher risk for getting that damage to your coronary arteries. So luckily we have very effective medicines for treating Kawasaki disease so that that inflammatory damage doesn't happen to your coronary arteries. So it's a medication that you would receive in the hospital. It's an intravenous medicine. It's a potent anti-inflammatory. And using that along with aspirin is extremely effective in preventing that damage to the coronary arteries.
Are you anticipating that we may start to see more cases of this in West Michigan?
I think it's possible. In general, West Michigan has not had nearly the number of cases of the novel coronavirus. So in some ways you would think that maybe we won't have very many cases of it, but we have seen cases in pediatrics been trickling through. And so I would anticipate that we will see some. We have three cases at the Children's Hospital that are suspected to be related to coronavirus that hasn't been confirmed yet, but that could slowly increase. Now, just one important message is that Kawasaki disease is actually triggered by a number of different viruses, influenza, other common cold type viruses. So it's not just coronavirus. No matter what virus triggers Kawasaki disease, you still need the same treatment. So in some ways, yes, it's nice to know if it was related to coronavirus or not, but still you have to get that appropriate in-hospital treatment to prevent that coronary artery damage.
All right. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us explaining a little bit more about the disease and the importance for parents to be able to get their kids to the treatment that they needed if they do suspect that they have this. And so I've got more information for you on 13onyourside.com.
Thank you, Val.